This video is sponsored by Envato Elements. Right now, I'm going to show you how to warp reality by using the Puppet Warp tool inside of Photoshop. Hey, Cafe crew, Colin Smith here from Photoshop Cafe. Let's jump in and use the Puppet Warp tool. There's a few little tips that you're going to pick up here, even if you already know how to use this tool. All right, so the first thing I want to do is I want to pop this flamenco off the background. So what I'm going to do is go to our little object selection tool. With that selected, we're going to choose select subject. Get a little bit of a selection around there. Let's pop it off. Control J, we'll copy that to a new layer. So that's what we've got there. Excellent. Now what we want to do is we want to fill underneath so we can have a blank slate underneath. So holding down the control or the command key, click on the thumbnail of the layer we want to select. That's the outline, even though it's hidden. Go down to the background. And what we're going to do is we want to expand this a little bit so we can fill it. So we're going to choose select, modify, expand. 5 pixels will work nicely. Click OK. So now we've got a 5 pixel selection all the way around here, and we want to just basically get rid of the flamingo. So we're going to hit the Shift Delete key. That would be Shift Backspace on Windows. Make sure we're choosing Content Aware. Click OK. And should do a pretty decent job of getting rid of everything. You can hit Control D to hide this selection. It's not bad, it's not perfect, but it's good enough for what we want to do. And here's our top layer. Now we're going to manipulate this and have some fun with it. So what I'm going to do though is I want to have 2 copies. So we're going to right click, we're going to choose Convert to Smart Object. Then we're going to move it over. I'm holding down the Shift key to constrain it. And let's make a copy. Control J, Command J on Mac will give us a copy. Control Command T for Free Transform. Right click, and we're going to flip horizontal. And now we're going to drag this across. And now we have 2 copies of it. Let me just select both these layers and just nudge them so they're nice and equal. Great. Now we're going to have some fun manipulating them. But before I do, I just want to let you know, I grabbed these particular images from Envato Elements. So Envato Elements is a great resource for all kinds of things. There's 55 million assets here. As you can see, there's stock photos, so I grab these a lot. I also use this for stock video that I use in my videos. And of course, you get sound effects, music, graphics, templates. We get presentation templates. There's all kinds of things like this that we can just grab and use. There's also fonts and Photoshop add-ons, things like actions, presets, brushes, layer styles, and so much more. So everything you download and you use comes with a simple license where it's licensed even for commercial work, and you get all of this for around $16 a month. So check out the link underneath in the description where you can go check it out. Let's continue with this project. So because of the nature of a smart object, whatever I do to one will happen to the other smart object as well. So let's double click the smart object. This is going to open this inside a new window. So what we're going to do is let's view them side by side. So if we go under Window, Arrange, Tile Vertically, we can see there's our image on the left and here's the one we're working with on the right. Let's do our Puppet Warp. So just choose Edit, Puppet Warp. Now what we want to do is just add a couple of points here. What that's going to do there is it's going to pin these. Let's pop one there as well so it doesn't move. Now, all we need to do if we want to change this is just add a point and we can drag this in. And notice how we can literally just move this. It's so much fun. So why don't we just anchor the head in there a little bit. Let's stretch the neck out a little bit more. Great. Why don't we add another point on the beak and we're going to pull that down a little bit. And if we want to bend it, notice how much control you have over this. So why don't we preview and see how this looks on our final image. So let me just hit the S for save. And of course, we're going to apply it. Oh, that's looking good. Why don't we bring these two closer together? Let's click back on our regular one. Let's nudge the one there over. Let's nudge the one there over. Oh, we're almost there. I think you can see what I want to do here. So let's choose the contents of the smart object. We're going to choose edit. We're going to do puppet warp. And I like where everything is here. So I'm just going to pin those so they don't move too much. And then I'm just going to grab the head and just pull that back just a little bit. Control S for save. Watch it update on the main document. All right, we're very close. But why don't we do something on here? Because I don't want them to look perfectly exactly the same. So I'm going to change one of them. Why don't we grab this one still with the smart object? We can close out the contents. We don't need that anymore. But we're just going to choose the edit puppet warp. And yes, see, it works on a smart object. So I'm just going to lock that into position. Let's grab the beak. Let's just kind of lock these other places in there. And just grab the other beak. Pull it in. So the puppet warp is another powerful way of transforming in Photoshop. Check out my other tutorial where I show you how to use the split mesh tool as well. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you learned anything new, let me know what you think in the comments underneath. And by the way, if you're new, welcome to Photoshop Cafe. Consider hitting the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my videos. So anyway, guys, do me a favor, hit that like button. It helps us with the algorithm in YouTube. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.